Well, despite hailing the deal with Iran, U.S. President Obama said the majority of American sanctions against Iran will stay in place. RT's Ghana Chikan has more from Washington.
President Obama pledged, quote-unquote, a modest relief of sanctions in return for Iran scaling back its nuclear program. Now, the relief will include freeing up a small portion of Iran's overseas accounts, as well as easing some other trade restrictions. Here's actually what the president said.
On our side, the United States and our friends and allies have agreed to provide Iran with modest relief while continuing to apply our toughest sanctions. We will refrain from imposing new sanctions, and we will allow the Iranian government access to a portion of the revenue that they have been denied through sanctions. But the broader architecture of sanctions will remain in place, and we will continue to enforce them vigorously. And if Iran does not fully meet its commitments during the six-month phase, we will turn off the relief and ratchet up the pressure.
Well, again, as President Obama said, the U.S. would refrain from imposing new sanctions because it would undermine the breakthrough deal that they just reached with Iran. We know that the U.S. Congress was just about to pass another round of sanctions, and the president has urged Congress not to do that. Now, although the Obama administration now says sanctions have worked in these negotiations, others argue that sanctions have created this hostile environment, which throughout all these years made it impossible to reach a deal. But still, even though there is a temporary agreement, the parties have already come out with what seems to be different interpretations, especially on the key issue of whether or not Iran has the right to enrich uranium.
We believe that the current agreement, the current plan of action, as we call it, in two distinct places, has a very clear reference to the fact that Iranian enrichment program will continue and will be a part of any agreement, now and in the future.
This first step, let me be clear, this first step does not say that Iran has a right to enrichment. No matter what interpretive comments are made, it is not in this document. There is no right to enrich within the four corners of the NPT, and this document does not do that.
President Obama, on his part, said Iran should have access to peaceful nuclear energy, but because of violations in the past, he said Iran should be strictly limited in its capacity to develop a nuclear program. Now, we have to take into account that the Obama administration is now under a lot of pressure from the U.S. Congress, which is hardly in favor of any deal with Iran, and its allies, Israel and some of the Gulf states, which don't want to see Iran's sanctions relieved. So, President Obama, President Obama, as well as Secretary Kerry, they had to word their statements very carefully, and ultimately their message to both Israel and their partners in the Gulf was that this deal will eventually make everyone safer.
Well, let's discuss this further with Asia Times correspondent Pepe Escobar. Pepe, good to have you with us as always. So as we see the U.S. Secretary of State John Kerry and Iran's Foreign Minister Mohammed Zarif came out of these talks with different plans. So why, in your opinion, is there such a difference in diversity, I should say, in interpretation of the deal?
Because the spin war has started at 3 a.m. in Geneva. And it's going to be going for another 6 months until May 2014. That's the duration of this first step deal. Very, very important. Kerry had to say that so he could appease the Israel lobby, the U.S. Congress, and the Wahhabi petrodollar lobby in the U.S., not to mention some neocons in the U.S. as well, still very powerful. And in Iran, it's different. They are saying, we still have our right to enrich uranium, and it's correct, because they will keep enriching uranium to 5% for the next 6 months. 20% is frozen. They will discuss for the next deal, which will be the definitive deal, starting in May 2014. And all the 20% enriched uranium that they have is going to be diluted. So it can't be used later on for weapons-grade materials.
Well, Pepe, also, okay, Pepe, as you said, the spin war started, but how will it affect the implementation of the deal now and 6 months down the road? Who will eventually benefit from it? I mean, if the two sides have such a diversity of opinion, I mean, won't they at some point stall?
No. We have to follow the letter of the agreement. This means enrichment until 5%, okay. No enrichment until 20% for the next 6 months. No new centrifuges. If Iran follows all this, they are abiding by the deal. No problem. The thing is, if among these IAEA inspectors, which will be on Iran practically on a daily basis from now on, if you have the usual infiltrators who start spinning something else, I'm sure Iran won't break their promises. It's in their own interest not to break any promise.
Well, in light of the negotiations between Iran and Washington, there's some detail that's emerged just recently, which is, in fact, really interesting to look at and be great to have your thoughts on this. Well, what's emerged, Washington's been engaged in secret talks with Iran long before the Geneva Agreement, and even the closest allies were unaware of this. So what do you make of this?
Well, of course. Look, this is an extremely complex negotiation. You can imagine that you had Sherpas going to Geneva a month ago or 3 weeks ago and hammer out the final deal so we have foreign ministers to sign. It's impossible. Sherpas start this thing usually months in advance. And obviously, we had American Sherpas especially, Iranian Sherpas, and Russian Sherpas as well. These are the ones that count. Britain and France, these are spectators. They don't count at all. France counted because in the 20% matter, they cornered the market on medical isotopes. And if Iran enriches to 20% and starts selling their own medical isotopes cheaper, especially to the developing world, it's not a good deal for France. Mm-hmm. So for the moment, France is protected. France's business interest is protected.
Okay,
right?
Let's now go to America's assessment of the situation and specifically what President Obama said. I mean, looking at the deal that was reached in Geneva today, he said that this is just a first step to reach a comprehensive solution in the future. So what, in your opinion, will make a full agreement? And what will Washington consider, for the matter, a full agreement?
Look, Obama is correct when he said this is a first step. But very important, the way he said it was very condescending, even insulting to Iran, in fact. He was placing all the onus on the Iranians. No, the sanction regime is completely absurd, in fact. And it should be dismantled because most of these sanctions, they bypass the UN, like Sergei Lavrov has been saying for months, in fact. Very important. For the next few months, follow the money. The Americans say they are going to unfreeze some of Iran's, it's $32 billion, perhaps even more. There are 10 billion in European banks. These are not going to be frozen. Probably if the Americans unfreeze like 4 billion, 5 billion, they could do it by executive order by Obama because they can bypass the U.S. Congress
well,
for that.
You know, speaking of sanctions, as you just said earlier, I just want to quickly ask you, John Kerry, on the contrary, believes that sanctions did their job. In fact, they were quite instrumental and helpful in sealing this deal. To what extent do you agree or disagree?
Well, the Iranian population paid the price for the sanctions, in fact. The Iranian government, they found ways to bypass it. They're selling or bartering or trading energy, especially with their Asian customers. Look, you know how much money Iran has in mostly Asian clients? China, Japan, Turkey, which is part of Asia as well, South Korea. $50 billion, and they still cannot bring this cash back to Iran. They have to buy products from these countries. So this is something that must be hammered out in the next agreement. For the moment, we have a breakthrough. It's going to last 6 months. There will be all sorts of interests who try to bombard this deal. And I'm saying especially the Wahhabi petrodollar GCC monarchy interests and Israeli lobby as well. But for the moment, we have diplomacy in action, something that we haven't seen, especially between the U.S. and Iran, for 34 years. So this is the major breakthrough at the moment. But we have to be vigilant. There's
indeed,
no question.
Indeed, Pepe, yes, as you just rightly said, it was a groundbreaking deal achieved in Geneva today, and we've seen diplomacy at work. Pepe Escobar, Asia Times correspondent, thank you so much, as always, for your views here
thank
on
you.
RT.